there is the family. As you can see the tears flowing, that cup is going to be in that community for them for a day. They will celebrate with him.
Prince Edward Island is the smallest province in Canada. At some points, it's only 30 miles wide. The Stanley Cup will tour the entire province of Prince Edward Island.
He left home at 14 years of age, made his commitment to hockey.
There it is, Lord Stanley's Cup, first award at 1893. Let's go downstairs.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Stanley Cup!
In sports. First, let's congratulate the Calgary Flames on a great series and a great season, and their great fans. To win this trophy, it starts with ownership, and there's no finer owner in sports than Bill Davidson. This night is because of him. There are a lot of people in the organization to congratulate. You fans deserve congratulations for the great support you've given this team. But Dave Andreychuk has waited a long time for this trophy. I'm proud to present it, Dave, to you and your teammates. Well done. A great Stanley Cup run. Dave Andreychuk, come on up.
Leaders of the Tampa Bay Lightning, Dave Andreychuk and Tim Taylor, have meant so much to the head coach, John Tortorella.
And Vinny, you know, Vinny had a quiet couple of games until he exploded halfway through this one. And did this young man at 24 years of age come through for his club? It's all part of being great. And how about Marty St. Louis, probably the MVP during the regular season. What a job.
He's about 9 feet tall at this stage of his life.
This cup has 13 years of winners on each band, and one of the bands is coming off this year and gets retired. A new band will start. And this great, magnificent Lord Stanley's Cup, you saw when Andreychuk took it, his teammates. There he is. There's Bill Davidson, the owner. Got a chance to have both the NHL Stanley Cup and the NBA trophy in the same year, as he is also the owner of the Pistons. Moment. This Tampa Bay team finished first in the East regular season. When they started their run, there weren't many who gave them a chance to win it. Even fewer gave Calgary a chance to be in it.
That's Dan Boyle, who had most of his home burned down during this series. Recovered from that without a wardrobe and played one whale of a game seven. Chris Dingman, one of the most valuable fourth line contributions I think I've seen in a long time.
Yeah, he said he learned a lot of it when he played for Colorado and won. How about Kavina? He and Sador, the two defensemen, the pairing, battled so hard to stop the great Jerome Iginla. What a difference they made.
The new shot block trophy will be named
the Kavina.
Thank you.
There's Daryl Sador, wins in Dallas. This one he's hugging, his knees bothered him, his back was sore, but he got it done. Out of nowhere, They were criticized in Tampa Bay when they made the trade with the Philadelphia Flyers. There's what a trade is made for, right there.
It's now 7 a.m. in Kiev, Ukraine, where Fedotenko's family is watching. And you know what? I'll guarantee you they're all up, even his four-year-old brother.
John Tortorella, the winning coach. Let's get out to Sam Ryan. Sam?
All right, thanks a lot, guys. Marty St. Louis, who took his bumps and bruises along the way in this series. Now, Marty, before this series began, you said no hard feelings against Calgary. It just didn't work out for you there. How sweet is this for you, though?
Oh, it's sweet regardless of... I started in Calgary. It's just an awesome feeling. I mean, you fight for this for your career, and we finally get one, you know, for Dave and all of us. We're very happy, and you got to take the hits at this time of the year. You can't retaliate.
Now, you downplayed your regular season success during the postseason, all about the team. How special is this team to you?
We're going to walk forever together. You know, no matter what happens from now on, we'll always walk forever together.
Okay, Marty, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Let's send it over to Darren Pang.
With the number one goalie this time of year, Nikolai Habibulin. Nick, in late March, your head coach, John Tortorella, openly asked if you were good enough to bring it all the way. How's this feel tonight, winning in game seven?
Well, it feels great. I think, you know, the whole team worked so hard all season, and, you know, I'm happy to provide them with a good goaltending, I guess. And, you know, I still cannot believe we did it, and it hasn't digested yet.
They had a little barrage on you in that third period. How did you stay sharp?
I tried to stay focused, play the puck a little bit behind the net, and I don't know, just I tried to do whatever I could to stay focused.
Great job, Nick.
Thank you very much.
Gary?
Those are the most words spoken by the winning goaltender in the entire Stanley Cup playoff run. They are dancing in the streets of Tampa Bay. They are the 2004 Stanley Cup champions.